This video is on the way how I can get from two faces which are connected tangent h, something like this. Okay, let's start. We start with some sketches to create the faces. We start this here. And the first thing what I do is I select all the sketches and transform the sketches to Bezier curves. Then I hide the sketches. So now I have the curves, which I use as edges for the faces. So I select three edges and create the product. And the same I do here. In this case, this edge has the false direction, so I have to switch one direction in the configuration of the second face. So now they are ready, so we have two faces. And both have joined this edge, but there is no tangent constraint between these faces here. So what I can do, I hide the grid. Now I use this both and create a face connection, connect faces. So I get this, and once more I have to change the configuration a little bit. I have here to reverse one mapping, and now I get here tangent constraint between these two faces. Both faces still lie or have the same border curve here. They join this curve and now they are tangent. The problem what I have now is that this tangent constraint has influence over a wide range of the face. To restrict this influence, I add some knots into these two edges. These are these two ones, so, and I can here add extra knots, and I say I add one at position dot two, and in this case I get something what has changed. To see the influence of this extra knot, I create for the faces B grid. I hide them. We see here is this extra knot inserted, and if I move it to this edge, then the influence of the tangent constraint will become smaller. I can also make the B grid of the result to see the difference. So this is B grid of the connection. And if we look inside this, I change the color. And the line width. Then we see here in the result, we have here a tangent flow. And here the blue and the pink curves are the source faces and there is no tangent constraint. So this is the difference, and now we also can look for the grid. So we can create a grid for all these components. This is the result. I change the color to see the difference. And now we can see here the pink are the source objects, and this one, the light blue one, is the result. And we have the same points here in a white area, and near the connecting edge we have a difference. And this is the result.